myself Ahmed Hussain Borboya of Department of Persian, SS College Hailakandi. Earlier we have supplied study materials for our students through our college websites, WhatsApp, etc. Now we are preparing video classes for the better understanding of our students. This is my first video class for HS second year Persian students. First of all, you know the syllabus. Our syllabus is comprised as two units, language one, unit one language, unit two literature. I will discuss about unit two literature. Literature, under literature unit, prose and poetry. There are five prose, that is Kalila wa Dimna, Hekayate Sher o Khargosh. Chapter 1, Kabus Nama, Tarare Amanatdar. Hafte Pekar Nizami Ghaznavi. Khudae Muhammad, Khudake Muhammad, and Tasir-e Farsi Bar Zaban wa Farhange Ashami. This is the five chapters included in your syllabus. And under poetry, poetries of Sheikh Sadi Shirazi, Adil Peshawari, poetry of Dr. Muhammad Iqbal, poetry of Iraz Mirza, and poetry of Parveen Etesami. Today I will discuss about first chapter, that is Kalila wa Dimna. First chapter, Hekayate Sher o Khargosh, taken from the book Kalila wa Dimna. You see in your book, textbook, that is, here is written Intikhabe az Kitabe Kalila wa Dimna. Intikhab means collection, as means from, Kitab means book, Kalila wa Dimna, name of a book. So, collection from the book Kalila wa Dimna. The book Kalila wa Dimna is written by Abul Mali Nasrullah Munshi. The story, Hekayate Sher o Khargosh, the story of lion and hare, is taken from the book Kalila wa Dimna. This is the short story, comprises 2.5 pages. Before going to the text, I would like to discuss about Kalila wa Dimna. You know, Kalila wa Dimna is a very important ancient book written by Abul Mali Nasrullah Munshi. Originally, this book is written by Vishnu Sharma in India in Sanskrit language. This book is one of the most valuable translated work made into Persian. This book on fables is translated into almost all the living languages of the world. Originally, the book was written in India by learned man Vishnu Sharma in Sanskrit language. The author has narrated short stories through bars and beads for the advice of human being. Later on, Buzurg Meher, the minister of Nosheerwane Adil, the just king of Iran during the period of Sassanid period, he was a king of Sassanid period, Nosheerwane Adil. His minister Buzurg Meher, he translated this book into Pahlavi language from the original version of Sanskrit. After this, an Arabic learned man named Ibn Mukaffa, Abdullah bin Mukaffa, he translated this book into Arabic from its Arabic Pahlavi version. In the subsequent century, Abul Mali Nasrullah Munshi translated this valuable book into Persian prose from its Arabic version. He dedicated the book in the name of the Ghaznavi Sultan Bahram Shah. Qalid-ud-Dimna is full of literary beauties. The book has been prescribed as a textbook in the Persian-loving countries in their syllabus of school and colleges. Now, the summary of the story is like this. In a forest or in a meadow, there lived innumerable various beasts due to the abundance of water and grass. But due to the presence of a lion there, all those peace and happiness had been disturbed. One day they gathered together. One day, they means animals, gathered together to go before the lion with a proposal to send a game every day at the time of a lion's breakfast, at the time of his breakfast. The lion consented to the proposal, and in that way a period passed. One day the turn came for a hare. He delayed for an hour and then started walking slowly towards the lion. In the meanwhile, the breakfast time was over, which turned the lion restless, and the water of his mouth had dried up. As he saw the hare rushing, he cried out to explain the cause of his coming late. The hare said the beast had sent another hare along with him for his breakfast. On the way, another mighty lion seized that one. The hare requested him to set the hare free for the breakfast of the king. But that lion did not pay any attention to his words. On the contrary, he oppressed him and threatened him to kill as well. He had rushed with his life to inform the king about the matter. The lion jumped up on hearing his words and asked the hare to show him that nonsense lion. The hare stood in front to bring him before a wall of clear, transparent water. He requested lion to took him up in his claws before showing the lion to him. The lion took him up and cast his glance into the wall. He saw the reflection of himself and that of the hare in the clear water. At once, he threw the hare away and jumped into the wall and dashed against the water to give up his sweet life. The hare came back safely and narrated the true story to the point. The beast became glad on hearing the story. They started dancing with joy. From that day, they had been living cheerfully in the meadow without any fear. This is the summary of Hekayat-e-Sher-o-Khargush, the story of lion and hare. The text of the story is like this. Hekayat-e-Sher-o-Khargush. You see the text is open the book. This is the first chapter, page number 1. Hekayat-e-Sher-o-Khargush. Awarde and Kedar Marguzari ke nasimi an buye behesta maatar karde bud. و عکس آن روی فلک را منور گردانیده و از هر شاخی هزار ستاره تابان و در هر ستاره هزار سپر حیران و اوهوش بسیار به سبب چرا خور و آب در خصب نعمت بودند لیکن به مجاورت شیر آن همه نعمت و آسایش منعز بود روزی فراهم آمدند و به نزدیک شیر رفتند و گفتند तू हर रोज पस आज रंज बिसियार व मुशक्कत फरावान आजमा एकी शिकार मीतवानी शिकार व मा पाए वस्ते दर मुकासात बला व तू दर तका पुए तलब अकनून चीजी आंदी शेद आयम के तुरा आज आन फरागत व मारा अमन व राहत बाशत अगर तारुज खीश आज मा जाइल कुनी हर रोज माँ मौज़फ़ एक ही शिकार बे वक्त चाश बे मतबुख मालिक फरस्तीम शेर बर आन रजादाद मुद्दती बर इन बे गुजाश्त एक रोज़ करगे बे खरगुश आमद यारान रा गोफ्त अगर दर फरस्ता जन मैन मुसामिहती कुनीद शुमार आज जूर इन जब्बार खुनखार व जान शिदान सितमगार बरहानम गुफ्तन मुजायकती नेस्त ओ साथी तौकुफ़ कर ता वक्त चास्त शेर बे गुजाश्त पस बहिश्तगी सूये ऊरा शेर रा तंग दिल दीद व आतिश ग्रोसनगी ऊरा बर्बाद तान निशानी दे व फरूग खशम दर हरकत सुकनात व पैदाम दे चुनान के दिहान ओ खश्क बुदन सो टुडे इज हियर आई शिल डिस्कस टेक्चुअल ट्रांसलेशन इन माई नेक्स्ट क्लास. Thank you, all of you.